Hey, 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 how are we going, people? Welcome to another video. A couple of months ago, I mentioned that I started my YouTube challenge. Let's see together what I've learned. I'm your host, Bob Wizard. Grab your cuppa, find a coffee seat. Let's do this. Let me just start by saying that I didn't realize that it's almost been 3 months when it was supposed to be two. Apologies. Now, what I've learned in almost 3 months in only making content on YouTube, full disclosure, I've been pushing my streams to travel as well in the past few weeks, but my main platform has been YouTube. I still push them to travel because I believe it's a good platform, even if my heart is with YouTube. Let's go over what I've learned in the past months. As you know, I started my journey on Twitch over 1.5 years ago. But in this past month, I haven't missed the platform at all. Why did I miss Twitch? Good question, guys. I have said this 100 times on my channel at least, but Twitch has zero discoverability for small streamers. Unless, of course, we as small streamers make clips to then export in vertical mode on YouTube as shorts or on TikTok, right? I found myself struggling to make clips to redirect my viewers to my Twitch channel. My content is gaming related, but it's not really gaming. So I had to make ad hoc gaming clips for Twitch. My workflow really suffered because I had to work double. Maybe it's not in your particular case, but my main channel is for content creation and unboxing, so I still make shorts for that type of content more than for gaming because it's my main content. I still live stream as well and play games on this channel, but I do it to hang out with my community, with my viewers. Relax, have a banter. If someone has a question, just pop it in the chat and ask them. I don't bite. But I don't have the stress anymore to having to deliver a great gaming show because it's me giving back to the community when I live stream. Speaking of streaming, now with YouTube, I can stream in 2K in 1440p. Then why limit myself to 1080p? YouTube allows me to do it, Twitch doesn't. I have been slacking off in the past 2 weeks, bit guilty. Yeah, I've had COVID and then, you know, the Christmas period, I've been posting a little bit less shorts than usual. But before I post some shorts, they had some good numbers. All the stress that I had, having to make numbers, now it's gone because my mind is clearer. I start color grading better in my mic when I edit, for example. I worked out a better lighting system for my stream and my recording studio. I don't know if you can tell, but you can see me a little bit better. Speaking of lighting, guys, I completely forgot to turn on my light strips. You will see in a minute, it will look even better. Oh my god, I was looking back at the video, I'm like, there's something missing, the image is very plain. Doesn't look better? Now let's go back to the video. I put some panels on the wall as well, so the quality of the mic should be better. We'll see. when I edit, I'll be able to tell. But see, I make content only for one channel, and this is the one that you're watching me from. All this thanks to the YouTube algorithm. If your content is worth being watched, YouTube will share your content more. It's all about quality in both subjects, execution, and presentation. Do you agree with what I said? Let me know in the comments down below. While you're down there, don't forget to pop the like button. That way, YouTube will share this video so I can help more people. Thanks for watching. As usual, happy creating.